Good morning, dear friends. Today's date is 9th May 2020, Saturday. Today, our grammar topic is pronoun. In our previous videos, we have learned about noun and adjectives. So, in this chapter, we have to keep it in mind that noun and pronoun and adjective, these three things play a very important role in the sentence formation. But pronoun here we are going to learn, correct? It is not similar to as adjective and as noun. Pronoun has got its value in the English grammar. So as we are going to learn this chapter, pronoun, I request you to keep a notebook and pen with you so that you can write your doubts and try to understand the things. So my dear friends, let's move towards the definition of pronoun. A pronoun is a word that is used in place of a noun. Correct? What is the definition? Pronoun is a word that is used in place of a noun. So here you can read the sentence. Rita is a good student. Rita completes her homework every day. Rita has many friends. Rita also dances well. Here you can notice that Rita has been used over and over again. So don't you think these sentences sound awkward? Why? Because already we have used Rita several times. And it doesn't sound good to use again and again same pronoun in the sentences. So what is the definition of pronoun is? A pronoun is a word that is used in place of a noun. So we are going to change these words of Rita into pronouns. So let's see the sentence, correct sentence. Rita is a good student. She completes her homework every day. She has many friends. She also dances well. So in these sentences, Rita has been replaced with she. Now we can say that these sentences are perfect. So as we read these sentences, we come to know exact meaning and the proper sense of the sentence. Have you understood? Very good. Now, there are types of pronouns. So again I said, there are some pronouns which are repeated in adjective also and here also. So first is personal pronoun. Second, demonstrative pronouns. Third, interrogative pronouns. Fourth, reflexive pronoun. Fifth, emphatic pronoun. And sixth, possessive pronouns. So we are going to learn each of them nicely in this unit. So let's get ready with the first personal pronoun. Pronouns which are used in place of the names of persons, animals, and things are called personal pronoun. So let us take this example. The book is lying on the table. Pick it up. So here the book is things. Correct? So here we can see that, okay, it is used in place of book. It is a personal pronoun. So in the pick it up, correct? We have not said again here, pick this book or pick the book up. So we have replaced the word the book with it. So that is how we come to know pronouns which are used in place of the names of person, animals, and things are called personal pronouns. Have you understood? So here the word it is a personal pronoun. Correct? So there will be other example, okay, which I have given you in the worksheet. Example that we have already seen in the previous slide. Correct? Rita is a good girl. So we have used she also becomes a personal pronoun. Have you understood, my dear friend? So personal pronoun, correct? In place of nouns, persons, animals, and things are called personal pronoun. So let us try to understand this personal pronoun in the form of this chart. So there are three forms of personal pronouns. First person, second person, and third person. So this personal pronoun is also becomes a singular and plural. So in the singular you can say in the first person, I, me, and it becomes plural, we and us. In the second person, you can see that you, you, it remains same. In the third person, he, him, she, her, and it. And in the plural, they and them. So you try to understand this chart, okay, how we have made these three personal pronouns into singular and plural form. So as we are going to learn ahead, we will understand how to make the use of these personal pronouns in our sentences. Got it? So here you have come to know the three personal pronouns with their singular and plural form. Have you got it, my dear students? It's very, very simple. We already used these words in our sentences. Now let us move towards the second pronoun, that is demonstrative pronoun. So don't get confused with the demonstrative adjective. Okay, here demonstrative pronoun is, this is a pain. So here word this, correct? It stands for demonstrative pronoun, correct? So here it stands for pain. Then that is a bat. So it stands for bat. So this that we are pointing out, correct? Demonstrative. So in this way, we come to know demonstrative pronoun, this and that, correct? And in other slide, next slide, you will see that how this and that changes into the plural form. So these are pencils. So this is standing for the pencils, correct? These are pencils which are given to me by my friends, correct? Those are books. So here those is standing for the books. So this is the demonstrative pronoun that we need to keep it in mind. Demonstrative pronouns are four. This, the plural form of it is these. That and the plural form of that is those. So it is very, very simple to understand demonstrative pronoun. You need to keep in mind these four words. Again, I'm telling you, don't get confused with the demonstrative adjective. It might sound similar, but it is different. Have you got it? Now pay attention over here. These, that, and those are pronouns. Since they point out to objects or objects that they refer to, they are called demonstrative pronoun. See the definition here I have given again. A demonstrative pronoun is a pronoun that is used to point out the object or objects which it refers to. In the example I have clearly given you, this is a pen, these are pencils, that is a bag, those are books. So if you see these words or sentences again and again, you come to know here that we are already pointing out towards the object. So therefore, it becomes the demonstrative pronoun. It is very, very simple, my dear students. Demonstrative pronoun is nothing but it points out towards the object. Have you got it? Do you think it is difficult? No, I don't think so. It is very difficult, but you keep it in mind that demonstrative four words, that the plural form of that is those, and this, the plural form of this is these. Correct? Have you understood what is demonstrative pronoun? It's very, very simple. Correct? So you need to always keep it in mind that demonstrative pronoun is a pronoun that is used to point out the object, as we have given in the following example. You can also add examples of your own by saying like, this is a car, that is my brother, okay, these are my friends, those are children. So you can go on adding or go on making sentences. In the third, interrogative pronouns. So what is interrogative pronoun that you will come to know by reading these questions? Who has come to meet me? What is the matter? Whom do you want to meet? Which is your book? So interrogative pronoun also, you have understood that it begins with the question, that is WH. So in these sentences, the words who, what, whom, and which are pronouns. They are used for asking questions and are known as interrogative pronoun. So you see the definition. An interrogative pronoun is a pronoun which is used for asking a question. So what is the use of this pronoun is in order to ask a question. Correct? So if you ask a question, you will get the answer in the form of noun. For example, who has come to meet me? Answer is Rohan has come to meet you. So you get the answer Rohan. Correct? Which is your book? This is my book. So here you get the demonstrative answer as well. So it is very simple. Keep it in mind that you need to always ask a question in interrogative pronouns. Got it? It's very, very simple to understand the interrogative pronoun. See again with the example that I have given you in the form of four questions. Correct? So these are all called interrogative pronouns. You also can form various sentences or various questions by using interrogative pronouns. Let's move towards fourth, reflexive pronouns. So here I am telling dear friends, don't get confused with this reflexive pronoun, though it will be similar to emphatic pronoun, but here try to understand what is reflexive pronouns. Reflexive pronouns are used when the object of the verb is also the subject of the verb. Correct? Now don't get confused with the definition. See the example over here. I helped myself. I and myself. Who has helped? Okay, the person has helped himself. Correct? I helped myself. So it is the object of the verb help. Correct? So myself and I stand for the same person. So the object is also the subject. Correct? So I is the subject, verb is a help, and myself becomes the object. But here, myself and I stand for the same person, so the object is also the subject. So it will be the subject. See, let us see the second example. They hurt themselves during the game. So here the word themselves is the object of the verb hurt. So they and themselves stand for the same person. So the object is also the subject. So what are the reflexive pronouns? Myself, ourselves, yourselves, yourself, himself, herself, itself, and themselves are reflexive pronouns. It is very, very simple, my dear students. Okay. So I help myself. They hurt themselves. In order to understand this, okay, I'll give you a simple tip that it will always come after the verb. Correct? So the reflexive pronoun will come after the verb. You need to keep it in mind. Got it? So keep it in mind that the reflexive pronoun will come immediately after the verb. See the example? I helped myself. So help is a verb. Then they hurt themselves. Hurt is also a verb. So you need to keep it in mind. What are the reflexive pronouns? They might be similar to the emphatic, but here you keep it in mind, it will always come after the verb. Got it? Okay. See again example nicely and remember the words which comes under this reflexive pronoun. Myself, ourselves, yourselves, yourself, himself, herself, itself, and themselves, okay, are called as reflexive pronoun. Correct? So it is very, very simple to understand reflexive pronoun. Got it? I'm again starting the fifth emphatic pronoun. So again, I'm telling, don't get confused with this. Okay? An emphatic pronoun is used with a noun or pronoun to draw attention or just to emphasize. So it is in order to draw the attention and emphasize. This will come immediately after the subject or after the pronoun. I myself solved the sum. So I myself, correct? I myself. So we are putting an emphasis. We are trying to get the attention. Look, ma'am, I myself solved this example. In the second, he himself is the best judge. And in the third, we ourselves are responsible for our mistakes. So you can see the stress and the emphasis which we have given, correct? It is always has come before the verb and after the pronoun or a noun. So here, which are the words will come in this emphatic pronouns? Myself, ourselves, yourself, himself, herself, correct? Are some emphatic pronouns. So here you see how we have to draw the attention or to emphasize, correct, by saying I myself solve the sum, correct? So here we are giving a proper stress on the sentence. He himself is the best judge. He himself, correct? We ourselves are responsible for our mistakes. So here again, we ourselves. So we are putting an emphasis, we are trying to get the attention by putting the emphatic pronoun immediately after the pronoun or a noun. Have you got it? It's very simple. Correct? So you have to give a stress. In the sixth, possessive pronouns. We don't use apostrophe to show possession. So don't get confused with the possessive. Correct? Here we are not going to use apostrophe S. The possessive pronouns are mine, his, theirs, ours, yours, and hers. So let us see the examples of this possessive pronoun. The bike belongs to you. Correct? The bike is yours. So we have taken out that belongs to you. We have put the bike is yours. Correct? Yours. The red handbag belongs to her. The red handbag is hers. See, you see here, we haven't put any apostrophe S. The hotel belongs to them. The hotel is theirs. The house belongs to us. The house is ours. The laptop belongs to him. The laptop is his. Correct? Understood? It is very, very simple. Correct? The pronoun it, correct, is never has its form of possessive. The word it's always used as possessive adjective. So the sentence will not have its. Correct? So the possessive pronoun is very, very simple. Correct? So here we don't use apostrophe S. Here we use the words like mine, his, theirs, ours, yours, hers. Correct? So these are the possessive pronoun. Keep it in mind. No need of putting apostrophe S. So these are the sentences without the apostrophe S. Have you got it? See, look at the example. Correct? We don't use apostrophe to show possession. Have you understood, my dear students? Okay. So in this chapter, we have done pronoun and types of pronoun. We have learned personal pronoun, correct? He, she, it, demonstrative pronoun, this, that, these, those, interrogative pronoun, WH type of questions, reflexive pronouns, correct? Myself, ourselves, theirselves, themselves, an emphatic pronoun, myself, himself, and possessive pronouns. It is, we are not going to use apostrophe S in this sentence. Got it, my dear friends? It is very, very simple. Okay. As you are going to get the worksheet, try to solve the worksheet properly. If you haven't understood any topic, you can refer to the video again and try to solve the worksheet which has been provided to you. Correct? So, thank you so much for watching the video and do your worksheet again and solve it properly. Thank you, dear students.